Hello everyone, my name is Van Ly. Today I'm going to present DNN-based detectors for massive MIMO systems with low resolution ADCs. Okay, let's start with the motivation. Over the last decade, we have seen an extreme increase in the number of users, connections, and services. This has been making the networks overloaded, and then massive MIMO comes in as one of the key solutions. The idea of massive MIMO is to use a large number of antennas as a base station in order to serve many users at the same time. In figure A, you can see it is a conventional receiver structure for one antenna. And when we scale up this structure to many antennas at a base station, the hardware cost and power consumption become critical issues. So one practical solution to save the cost and power consumption is to use low-resolution ADCs, because a low-resolution ADC has a simple structure and also very low power consumption. However, the system becomes severely nonlinear in case of low-resolution ADCs. And here, the idea is to use machine learning to address the nonlinearity, because machine learning is very well known for its ability of addressing nonlinear problems. Okay, now let's consider the maximum likelihood detection problem. The maximum likelihood detection method is used to recover the transmitted signal X given the channel matrix H and the received signal Y. There are two challenges here. One is about the feasible set, which is a discrete set and its size scales exponentially. So an exhaustive search is very expensive. And second, it is about a fee function. The fee function doesn't have a closed form expression, so it complicates the evaluation of the objective function. And now we will reformulate this maximum likelihood formulation in order to address the challenges. First, we exploit the fact that the phi function can be approximated by a sigmoid function. And so the objective function can be written in a closed form like this. And second, we relax the constraint on the feasible set from a discrete set to a continuous set, so that we can apply an iterative gradient descent method. And this is the structure of the gradient. Now we optimize the step size alpha, and the idea is to unfold the iterative method and consider each iteration as a layer of a deep neural network. And this is the structure of one layer of the proposed deep neural network. Here you can see that the weight matrix is defined by the channel matrix H. The bias vector is defined by the received signal Q up and Q low. The activation function here is the sigmoid function. It is not arbitrary, but results from the use of the approximation of the phi function. And the tunable parameters here are the step size alpha and the scaling parameter beta. So this is good because the channel keeps changing, so we need the weight matrix and the bias vectors to be adaptive. It is unlike the conventional DNN, where the weight matrices and the bias vectors are to be trained, and then after the training, the weight matrices and the bias vectors are fixed. So. And here I had some numerical results. First, I want to note that the solution given by the maximum likelihood method is optimal, but its complexity is exponential to the number of users, so it is very high. The solution given by the proposed DNN detector is suboptimal, but its complexity is just linear to both the number of users and the number of antenna at the base station. I also want to note that the proposed DNNs perform better than existing suboptimal methods, as you can see in these numerical results. For the conclusion, I have two messages. First, a good DNN detector needs to be adaptive because the channel keep changes. And second, it is very helpful to respond to the system model or structure when developing a DNN detector.